warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Indri Dita Ningsih. I'm from class A 2019 Biology Education at Mulawarman University. The purpose of me making this video is to fulfill the endless excitement from Miss Rukoya Nasution as my supporting lecturer. Today my theme is illegal logging. What is illegal logging? Okay, first I want to tell you about definition of illegal logging. Illegal logging is the harvest, transportation, purchase or sale of timber in violation of laws. The harvesting procedure itself may be illegal, including using corrupt means to get access to forest, extraction without permission, or from a protected area, the cutting down a protected species, or the extraction of timber in excess of a great limit. Illegality may also occur during transport, such as illegal processing and export, fraudulent declaration to custom, the avoidance of taxes and other charges, and fraudulent certification. So I want to tell you about overview of illegal logging. What is overview illegal logging? Illegal logging is a pervasive problem causing enormous damage to forests, local communities and the economy of producer countries. The EU, as a major timber importer, has implemented the European Union timber regulation as means to halt the import of illegally sourced wood products. The identification of illegally logged or traded timber is technically difficult. Therefore, a legal basis for normative acts against timber import or other product manufactured out of illegal wood is missing. 3. What is consequences of illegal logging? Many have consequences of illegal logging. Logging contributes to deforestation and, by extension, global warming, causes loss of biodiversity and undermines the rule of law. These illegal activities undermine responsible forest management, uncorrupt corruption and tax evasion, and reduce the income of the producer countries, further limiting the resource. Resource producer countries can invest in sustainable development. Illegal logging has serious economic and social implications of the poor and disadvantaged, with millions of dollars worth of timber revenue being each year. Okay. 4. I want to tell you about illegal logging in Southeast Asia, like in Indonesia. An estimated 73% of all logging in Indonesia is believed to be illegal. Most of the methods adopted for deforestation in Indonesia are illegal for a multitude of reasons. On the political front, the Indonesian governmental role in curbing deforestation has largely been satisfied. Corruption amongst local Indonesian officials falls significantly with regard to the governmental clampdown on illegal logging activities. In 2008, the acquittal of a proprietor for a timber firm, Adeline Lees, alleged for illegal logging further public opinion and real skepticism at the Indonesian political institution. The Indonesian government grapples with the management of deforestation with sustainable urban development as rural-urban migration necessitates the expansion of cities. The lack of accountability to deforestation with pertinence to transmigration projects undertaken by the Indonesian government illustrates minimal supporting evidence to testify to consideration for forestry sustainability in their development project. This further augments skepticism in the Indonesian government credibility and accountability and responsibility managing the urban development project and forestry conservation efforts. 2. In Myanmar, due to the size and scope of Burma's forestry, it is difficult for governmental organizations like FORES, difficult for government organizations like forest department to regulate logging. There is a high demand for timber from Burma's neighbor, notably Thailand and China, who have depleted their forests much more than Burma's plunder. As a result, numerous illegal logging operations have sprung up near the Thai-Burmese border and in the province of Kachin along the Chinese border. Logs are commonly cut on the Burmese side and then smuggled to utilities in China or Thailand. Okay, that's all for me about illegal logging. This word is enough to meet human needs, not to satisfy human needs. I'm Inryu Ditaningsih. Thank you for you guys, and thank you for Miss Rufaya Nasution. I end. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you.